This is Star Wars Nite. So our absolute first stop is here at the Starcade because for the first time in an After Dark event this year, we're coming in early. I told Angela, I was like, you know what? After that Disney Channel night craziness, we want to start early. So your ticket will get you in at 6 p.m. and you will have to wait in a huge line outside the park if you can't get a reservation to come in. So luckily enough, we had a reservation for today. So we're able to surpass the line, come straight to Starcade. You get your badge and you also get your map. Starcade is also gonna be where the merch is, but I wasn't really a fan of the merch. It's like 6 now, so we have about 2 hours, so I think we're just gonna probably map out the rest of the night and hope that we can get as much as we possibly can done. The time is now 8 p.m. We stopped at the Harbor Galley to try the Mos Eisley Spaceport cookies. This is 3 freshly baked chocolate chip cookies stacked with a sweet corn cereal whipped cream. Now, we ran into some friends and they were like, those are so tiny. And me and Angela literally said the same thing, but they're known for their cookies being really good. So let's see how they taste. So these cookies did not disappoint. If you've had the Harbor Galley cookies, they're literally the same thing. But like that whipped cream, I thought it was ice cream, but it is whipped cream. It like gives it that extra punch. These are a 5 out of 5, but I love cookies. So for me, gets that home run. Home run, 5 out of 5. If you're coming to Star Wars Night, get these. They're small. If you can get past that, you're gonna enjoy them. I think they're worth it. People are gonna laugh at you, but they're good. So we just got wrapped up with the lightsaber meetup, and I do have to say, it was still packed as ever. They do not let you stand up above the Millennium Falcon, which I was kind of bummed out about right by Docking Bay 7. They didn't let us stand up there, so we're basically in the pit. But same show as last year. I posted the full show in last year's video if you guys want to watch that. But nothing changed, so I didn't post the full show this year. We also got to run into C-3PO, and this was my first time seeing him in like years since he used to actually be out and around Disneyland. And I gotta say, that meet and greet is so cool. Prioritize that because seeing his suit looked amazing and there was no line. It was kind of like, just go crowd up and see if you could get close to meeting him. But after all of that, we stopped over here at Hungry Bear and I'm now gonna try the Dagobah Sunset Slush. It's lemon and mountain blast Powerade slush with strawberry puree and a glow key. Now honestly, the pro tip to this drink is stir it up. You already know, stir it up like Bob Marley. But when you stir it up, you get the lemon and the strawberry. Like at first, I just got straight strawberry puree to the face and it tasted like a strawberry slush, which was still good. And I think that's why my reaction was like, it's a strawberry slush, you know? But once I mixed it up, the lemon, me being a lemon lover, you guys know, it bumps this drink up and it's getting a little warm. So I'm gonna probably bump this. I'm gonna go 4-0. 4-0 out of 5. It's gonna get a real good. I recommend this. If you like lemon and strawberry, that's basically like a strawberry lemonade, but a slushy from Sonic, bro. That's what it is. Boom. Strawberry lemonade from Sonic. 4-0 out of 5, real good. Come try this if you're coming to Star Wars Nite.
So I am gonna try the La Mu burger, but this is a third Angus chuck patty, roasted sweet corn, poblano peppers, queso fresco, chili lime sauce, and avocado smash. This sounds delicious. I hope it tastes delicious. So Carson keeps asking me if I'm ready for a review. I've eaten about half of this burger. I didn't want to put it down. This thing is amazing. The corn, you can get like a little hint of like the sweetness of it, but it mixes really well with like the spiciness of the poblanos and the avocado in there. I love this. I wish they had it all the time and not just for Star Wars Night. I'm probably gonna give this a 5 out of 5, but I'm actually gonna give this home run. This thing is amazing. Come try this.
I hope that all of you are ready for the results of tonight's
So we literally darted from Hungry Bear over here to Main Street to do what's new. It's the Choose Your Path and it's under the entertainment. So I was expecting like a battle show between light and dark. And literally all you do is at the DJ booth, you scan a QR code and vote if you're a fan of the dark side or the light. And basically at the time, they just announced what side won, and then they just light up Main Street in the color. So like they lit it up for red because the dark side won at 9:45. No entertainment, no characters, no show. And like, look behind, half of Main Street's not even, doesn't even have projections. So I hope this doesn't sound negative, but I was just, what are we like? No fireworks if we got this. I don't know, on to the next one.
I would say underwhelmed. Like they, I just thought that they looked so much better above, it's not stage door. Where were they last
Golden
year?
Horseshoe?
Yeah, above Golden Horseshoe.
Yeah, that was last year.
Yeah.
I think really... it was like more like the energy, you felt the energy of the people and they were like, I don't know.
It was like exciting.
I mean, I love the Cantina band, right? But like...
they're always good. But yeah, like on the little boat, it's slow and you're just like...
The cool thing about it is there's not like a huge line or like, you need a cam for this.
That's true.
On to the Jawas. Hide your bag. You don't want them stealing the Beskar. Don't steal the Beskar. Oh my God. Run, run. They're going to steal it. They're going to steal it. Let me see. Oh, they're stealing my chain. Oh my gosh. We were robbed. We're so excited. We were robbed. Thanks, guys. Even though you robbed us. They're still being robbed.
Troops, fall in. We were informed there was a threat to the First Order in this area.
So we literally had to jet to Tomorrowland to catch the March of the First Order. And it was the same as last year and the years before. And I'm really not trying to sound negative because me and Angela are having a good time. But like, if you want to do all this stuff, this event is so packed with literally so much things to do. And you have to be extremely strategic and speed walk all over the place if you want to be able to capture all of this stuff. So now we're waiting for our mobile order. It's been a little over 10 minutes. We'll see how long it takes. It took about 20 minutes for our mobile order, a little longer than normal, but hey, we got it. So we are first gonna try the Duel of Sliders, going with the theme, light and dark. These are two chicken sliders
with dueling flavors of sweet and spicy, served with seasoned curly fries. Now, you guys know I'm not a big spice eater, so Angela's gonna do the spicy, but I'm gonna kick us off with the sweet.
I don't know if I can give her a fair review on this just because I like took all the coleslaw.
But anyway, I would say the seasoning and the chicken was pretty good. The chicken was a little too crispy for me, but that's being really picky. I don't know, there's no description on this, and I'm trying to like, it's kind of like a sweet and spicy, sweet and sour, like I don't know. It's almost like a buffalo sauce without the spice. I don't even know how to explain this. I don't really eat like sweet, tangy wings. But if you are coming to Star Wars Nite, I would probably give this a 3.8. 3.8, I'm gonna go real good. It's above a that's all right. 3.8, real good. I might recommend. Let's see what Angela thinks about the spicy one.
It wasn't spicy really at all. It just tasted like a chicken slider that had some like relish on the bottom, maybe a little bit of onions, but not spicy in the least bit. I would probably say the McDonald's spicy chicken nuggets are spicier than this. I'm probably gonna give it a 3 out of 5. I'm gonna say that's all right. So Carson kind of tagged me in on his dessert. We're gonna try the Wookiee Whoopie Pie. This is chocolate whoopie pie with caramel mousse and white, dark, and silver crunched pearls. So this thing is good. It's messy and really sweet, but it's super soft. It might be sweetness overload. Like, share this with somebody if you're not a huge sweets person, but it's really good. I'm probably gonna give it probably a 4.5 out of 5. I'm gonna still say real good.
Next up, I'm trying the Dagobah Swamp Water. I hope I'm saying that right. It's blueberry lemonade, Powerade Mountain Blast, apple juice, and green lime glaze. Now, the coolest thing about this is there's a little frog in there. So this thing's pretty good. I'm kind of in the middle with it though, because it tastes like a blueberry lemonade. Like, you get a little bit, a hint of the apple, blueberry lemonade, not super tart. And for me, lemonade, I don't like when it's crazy tart. I'm probably gonna go like 3 out of 5. That's all right. Would I recommend? Sure, if you want something refreshing. But if you're only gonna get a couple of drinks, go get the slush from Hungry Bear. That was way better. So we darted over here to try to meet the Ewoks. And it's, well, at that time it was 12:30 and they cut us off. So they say the event goes till 1 a.m. I'm honestly a little upset that they cut us off at 12:30 before getting to meet any characters. There's just so much to do. So we're like, you know what? Let's go to Oga's Cantina. We still have some time. 12:35 we got there, they said they're closed. I would recommend, if you can't get anything done by 12:30, you're probably not gonna be able to get in line for any characters, go to Oga's Cantina, or really do anything else aside from the DJ party on Main Street. So, unfortunate news, but we did the best we could, and I kind of feel like we did a lot. We tried some food. Would I recommend? If it is your first time, yes, I would recommend. If it is a possible second time coming, tickets are not sold out, so you can still get tickets. I would not recommend. We had a decent time, but a lot of same old stuff. Stuff we didn't do in this video, go check out last year's video. I'm gonna put it right here. We did some different things that were offered this season. Definitely check out this video and last year's video. But until next time, what can I say except you're welcome? See you on the next one.